So now that wash day has been saved by the use of a new dryer, we can put on a load. We can shove a load in. So that's the load. I also put a mop head in there who's wet, so it has been used. So we've got one pod to pod in there. So we can shut that and go to that is. Oh, glitch. That is 90 quid. How's that? So yeah, with only one of those in, it made sense to go for a 90 than the usual 60 or the 40 because of the not really having much suds in it. It's more useful for 90 degree cycle. Right, washing machine is at 90 degrees. It feels really hot to touch. You barely touch it. Because there's 1 hour 24 left on the clock. And of course, dirty water.
Yeah, table service.
But yeah, the suds have actually pumped up well from just one.
Yeah. Not even after I took my job, I still looked like, oh, right. chop the bacon up, babe?
No,
see the hole.
Right, so we continue the washing machine. Now it's second intermediate spin. It's already unbalanced, and it, of course, is at almost 8.5 PM. The water is starting to become crazy in there. Even actually shaking the hoover, so here comes the backfield. Right, washing machine's like the final rinse. Basically now all water in there, and it's clean, so that means that all the dirt has probably been eliminated from the tea towels or the kitchen where cleaning equipment.
So you're
still
leaving, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good, thank you.
Where's he here?
He's in Manchester. He's in Manchester. He's coming around, not this weekend, next weekend. So yeah?
Boyfriend?
I think he's got a girlfriend.
Girlfriend? Yes.
final spin on the machines. Who's gonna do this one? Here it goes. And the very first time it starts, of course, it's shaking the dryer upstairs, but doesn't seem to be making that much noise with it on. It's not even making any much noise with it on top anywhere. Bit of water activity in the bottom. Oh my god, that washing machine's starting to go crazy now. Sud spitting in there, of course. But the thing is, lucky it's not doing any silly, other silly stuff like this coming out or anything like that. But it's still shaking the dryer upstairs, but not by much. And yeah, it's safe to say that the washing machine's at 1300 RPM as well. Now, now that the wash is finished, turning washer off and opening door so we can now see, use this dryer. I'm gonna have to take this out. Oh goodness. Yeah, ignore one of my staff members, funny thing is, but open that, and then, right, and we have put it on the tower, cycle. Which I say is probably that one. Oh wow. That sounds a lot better than the Beckham. Good thing is that you've got windows, so you can more or less see through the and see how things are doing, but of course it condensates up quite quick, so the good thing real quick, so I guess the heater comes up quite well on this Huber VTC 5911 NB. Do some cleaning work down there. Now, of course, we've got, of course, a lot of stuff in this bag that I don't think has been, stuff that haven't been done. I think this was stuff from downstairs as well that haven't been done. Just there we go. That is the load, very bulky indeed. And of course it has the dirty stuff in there too. Shut the door and put it on Cotton's 90. Meanwhile, there is a lot of dust and mop head stuff right on the window of that. And when I put my hand on there, it has got a very nice hot feeling to it. So there's a show that the Hot Point Vision Tech dryer works perfect. telling me how much is by next morning the it'll be going into the dryer. And this dryer definitely does longer other left tumbles. So that's about wraps up today's wash day, and I hope all of you like this new Hoover Vision Tech condenser tumble dryer. So thank you for watching my X-Files, and I'll see you again next time, slugheads.